How's everybody doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm great. Ms. Mo, I've been saying that all week. Yeah. How you doing, Kevin?
I'm good. I just woke up.
Okay, cool. You look like it. How you doing, Julie?
Good. I absolutely love this song. Great choice. Great way to kick off the event. Props to you.
Thank you. It's a vibe.
Hey, you gotta mix it up a little bit. All right. Everybody's trying to come in, so I'm gonna stop. All right, we gotta end Mario for a little bit so we can get it popping. How's everybody feeling? Okay. All right, so as everybody gets in here, I'm gonna go ahead and introduce myself. My name is Tyler. I'm a fourth-year marketing student at The Ohio State University with a minor in music media and enterprise. I'm an intern with Finessed Media, and I'm your host for today. How y'all feeling?
Hey.
How y'all feeling? Okay. So we got a very special event for you guys. We ask that everybody turn your cameras on and leave your mics off so we can see your beautiful faces, but we ain't got here nothing going on in your life, all right? Is that cool, everybody? Let me just get a thumbs up on the screen or something. You shake your head, yeah. That's all we need. Yep. Cool, cool, cool. So, yeah, we got a lot of people in here today, so I'm going to go ahead and call on some of y'all. Y'all give me y'all name, where you located, your reason for being here, and what you're currently bumping. Let me see. All right, Wendy, can you answer that for me?
Hi, can you guys hear me?
Yep.
Hi, I'm Wendy. I'm from LA. I graduated in PR and marketing, and I'm hoping to pursue that further and network with all of you guys and get to know you guys.
Okay.
Happy to see you.
And what you currently bumping?
I'm sorry?
I said, what you listening to?
Mario too. It's always on my playlist. Yeah.
Yeah, we love Mario around here. All right. Courtney, what's your well, I already know your name, but where you located, your reason for being here, and what you're currently bumping.
Hey y'all. All right, I'm Courtney. I'm from Dayton, Ohio.
Okay.
I'm a songwriter and a music manager. So I'm here to learn more tips and strengthen my skills. And let's see, what's the last thing I listened to? I think it was a Kehlani song. I can't remember which one it was, but it was Kehlani.
Mm-hmm. So, okay, cool. How about you, Jarrell? Where you located? What's your reason for being here and what you're currently bumping? Jarrell?
You got me?
Mm-hmm.
You got me?
You said what?
Okay, so, yeah, I'm Jarrell. I'm here. I'm from the Bay Area. Reason being here, elementary, basically. So, you know, she put me on, brought me here. What have I bumping? You know, a lot of Toby Lou, a lot of Jack Harlow. Two of the favorite artists I've been listening to.
Cool, 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 cool. All right, I'm gonna ask one more. I see you, Cartier. How about you? Give everybody your name, where you located, your reason for being here, and what you're currently bumping.
So right now, my name is Cartier. I'm in Columbus, Ohio. I'm the owner and head manager of a music management firm here in Ohio called Carnelian Productions. Let's see, I'm here to learn more tips about artist management so I can pass them on to the different area managers I'm training right now before our launches. And right now, I'm really bumping Cali Uchis's new album from this past December. It was called Sin Miedo del Amor y Otros Demonios. Like that's been my shit. So I've been playing that nonstop and I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
All right, for sure. So we're gonna go ahead and get it popping. Okay, I'm glad everybody came out. I appreciate everybody for being here. So before we get started, I wanna make sure everybody's engaged and interacting with me. So last week we did the snaps, you know, when you mess with something. So I came with my own thing. I want y'all to give me that Birdman hand rub when y'all mess with something, all right? I want to see everybody do it right now. Give me them Birdman hand rubs when you mess with something. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I like that. I like that. All right. So we're going to go ahead and get started. Welcome to our Industry Insights event on public relations and artist management. Once again, I'm your host, Tyler, and we're mad excited to have you. So today we'll be joined by two very special guests, Jocelyn Rivera and Aliyah Moore, aka Ms. Moore. And I hope y'all got y'all pen and paper ready because y'all gonna want to take some notes for sure. We're gonna talk about topics like building industry relationships, building your team, and how our guests got to where they are today. So y'all ready? Y'all ready? Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna do that all day. So y'all gonna get tired of me. So the way the agenda is gonna go, we're gonna do the interview till about 12:30. Then we're gonna move into the Q&A. Then we're gonna go into listening session around 1. Then we'll be done around 1:30. So pretty simple. All right. So without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and intro our very special guest. We got two very strong, beautiful Black entrepreneurs in the building. We got the CEO of Press Play, Jocelyn Rivera out of NYC. And we got the CEO of Moore Enterprise, Aliyah Moore, aka Miss Mo, out of ATL. So let me give them. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and give the floor to our panelists so they can give us some background on themselves and their careers and how they got to where they are today. So you can go ahead and start off for me, Miss Moore.
Actually, I know you've already talked about it a little bit, but I definitely went to school for engineering at first. I was electrical engineering. Didn't like it, switched my major to integrative studies with a minor in PR. That's how I realized that that's what I wanted to do. The more PR classes I took, the more writing classes I took. I also got my PR agency ready certification through the PR council. And on top of that, I did a couple of internships at Ask April Love, 106 Live Radio, also at Rare Sound Studios. I'm sure that you all are familiar with that. That's Kate Kemp's label. So that's kind of how I got started, hands-on experience, and when I realized that this is what I wanted to do. So from there, I started my own business. Ironically, I started my own business at the top of the pandemic, unfortunately. But it has still been great, and it's been a blessing. I've been working nonstop, and I just recently gained 2 new clients. So business is going well, and that's really how I got started.
Okay, cool. All right, can you go next for me, Jocelyn?
I was like, all right. But so I'm not doing like a background on myself?
Yep. Okay. Just give us a background on yourselves and how you got into your career.
Okay. So my name is Jocelyn. I'm a CEO and founder of the Press Play Agency. I started about 3 years ago now. So I started off kind of blogging for a lot of hip hop sites. Then I was still in college at the time, so I was just blogging, kind of getting my name out, doing like mainstream stuff. Then I started helping out this lady in this, like, she had like a, I guess you could say like an event space in Brooklyn. She needed somebody to help her out with like PR stuff, you could say like social media, getting people in the door, whatever. So I started throwing like a showcase for like independent artists. It started to, you know, get a lot of traction in Brooklyn. So I started to start, like, blog about the artists. They started asking me, like, what else can you do or whatever? And I'm like, oh, I mean, I don't know. Like, what else is there to do besides, like, blogging? I wasn't really, like, into PR or management at the time. I didn't know much about it. So people started telling me about it, but I was still in college. So I'm like, whatever. So I started doing, like, PR. I started off, like, because I had so many blog sites, I started to kind of create an angle for them, release it on a lot of these blog sites, pitch it to other bloggers that I knew, and kind of get it out there. It started to do well, so I started to kind of gain clients, I guess, and, you know, it was helping me pay for, like, you know, regular stuff in college, so it was, like, kind of going smooth. So when I graduated, it was kind of crazy. Like, I was in my little group chat with my friends. I'm like, girl, I think I'm not going to get a job. Like, I think I'm going to just do this. Like, I think I'm going to do this full time. Everybody's like, you crazy? Like, you don't know, like, the world is crazy out here, whatever. It's hard to find a job. Mm-hmm. Like, whatever, I'm going to try it out. So what I started doing is started reaching out to different, like, managers and A&Rs and different labels and, you know, mainstream, like, bigger labels, because I was trying to just kind of get, like, move really fast. So basically, I started freelancing for Shady Records, and I was basically doing PR for them. They taught me, like, you know, how to pitch, how to reach out to people. I was doing creative marketing kind of strategies for the artists that were coming in. I was doing consulting for the artists, just like really learning the ins and outs. So that was cool. So that was like my first freelance job out of college. So I was doing that for a while. And I started freelancing at Def Jam when they merged with Shady Records. So I was doing a lot of their new artists, helping them out with some stuff. Doing that for a while. Then I just kept doing shows or whatever. So I threw this really big show February of, I think it was 2017. somebody had like this really big venue in Long Island City and they wanted to fill it up. So I was like, okay, cool. I'm gonna just invite like a bunch of artists that I like or whatever. The show went really, really well. And I ended up inviting like A&R from Empire, A&R from 300, Atlantic. Somebody ended up getting signed. Somebody got a distribution deal and it just kind of blew up. So they all were like, started to like ask me like, how can I help them find artists, whatever. So then I started working, doing project management with Empire. I started doing freelance for Atlantic Records. I started doing just a bunch of like freelance projects. And then they were like, okay, like you have to start a company because we have to pay it. Like you have to, you know, pay you like, you know, on the books or whatever. So I had JAR PR, which is like my PR kind of thing. I didn't really know what I was doing. So then I launched a press play agency, which was, you know, encompass of like management and creative strategy and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, that started to blow up. So then I started to, then I got my, I guess you could say first mainstream client through Atlantic. So I started managing Don Q. I'm still managing him, but that was like my first client because they were like, they really liked my style and I was helping them with like smaller artists. So they were like, you take somebody that has a name. Then with Empire, they gave me Chef G and Sleepy Hollow. I don't know if you guys are familiar with him, but if you guys are from New York, they're pretty big. Yeah, they're really dope. They're like big in the drill scene. So I got them when they first came out and my job was to basically get them to a more mainstream name and then get them signed to a major deal. So that was really cool. I worked on basically like coming up with a strategy. You'd be surprised. Like if you're from New York, you know them, but people from other places, they didn't really know them and they didn't want to cover them too much. So I really had to like push a lot of different angles or whatever. So yeah, I threw a lot of events for them in the city, like with a lot of like fame, like influencers and DJs in New York that were big, whatever, to come and whatever. So yeah, so then I started getting them on the radio and all that kind of stuff. So they blew up, whatever. I'm trying to like put my life into like a little bit a little small piece, but so yeah, so I did that or whatever. Then I worked their first projects, their second projects, and then signed them to a major deal with RCA, and that was like a big moment for me because I felt like, you know, like that was like an accomplishment. You know, I'm still 25, but like it was like a moment in my career or whatever. But so that was that. But yeah, I guess you could say like some of my other highlights was like I used to manage DJ Drewski from High 97's website. So I basically like recreated his whole brand. So that was basically the new movement site. So like I hired bloggers and that was like my first transition into like not blogging myself and like kind of more pitching and managing a site or whatever. So I was doing that and that was cool. I did the same thing for the Rap Fest. I was the editor in chief over there. So that's when I kind of left blogging. I just wanted to make sure I say that because like blogging was like a big part of my life too. But then I transitioned to like more like editor kind of role. So then that's when I learned how to like really figure out what journalists want to read and like what the angles are and stuff like that. So yeah, that's my career, I guess. Yeah, in a nutshell.
Man, you've been busy, huh? You
only real busy. Real busy.
Great. Hey, you got me feeling like I'm 21. I need to get
come
get
on, start like, up.
I'm a little behind. But no, we're gonna go ahead and get this interview started. So my first question is, so you clearly, you know, you were in a lot of positions that kind of allowed you to, you know, easier access to get relationships. But as far as somebody who's, you know, just fresh into the industry, an artist or someone who's aspiring to be an artist manager, how do you like build a relationship with people in labels and brands when you don't really know anybody? And we'll start with you, since you're already talking.
Well, so when I first started, like, it's crazy because, like, I kind of feel like I was doing what everybody was doing now, which is, like, reaching out to people via the internet. Because, like, you know, now that we kind of have to, it's like you're forced to. But I was kind of doing it when everybody thought you had to meet people in person. I was, like, kind of, like, attacking, like, the digital space or whatever. So, like, my first mentor, he's now A&R at Def Jam. But he always said I was, like, a digital relations. I wasn't really a public relations, and I was like, oh, I always like I didn't get it till like later on. I'm like, I mean, it's the same kind of thing, but it's really not. Like working the internet is a whole different kind of scene. So what I really did was I just DM'd everybody. So when I went to college for human development, so I was really good with like speaking and words and putting together like a really compelling sentence. And you know, you only get like, at the time, I feel like they kind of cut you off, if I'm not mistaken, on Instagram DM, like you couldn't type too much. So I had to like keep it real short, but to the point, and make sure I get my like my passions across and my the things I was good at so that they could like take me on or whatever. So basically I just kind of like, I like this template that I would use for like A&Rs, for DJs, for other, like for big managers and blah, blah, people that I was looking up to. And I would just kind of like craft it based on like, okay, like I saw something that they did, or I could help them with something, or hey, I'll write these press releases for you, or I'll write these blogs for you or whatever, like offer my services to them, even though I didn't have like services per se, like I have now, but like offer my help, I guess. In this like really well-crafted DM. I didn't really do email, which I know people do a lot, like, you know, that's important too, but I didn't really email people. I just DM them because I was following certain people and I was getting people to follow me back. It kind of helped me. So they were like, okay, cool. Maybe she is somebody that I should follow back or whatever. Or maybe I'll respond to her. So that's what I was doing. And then, you know, pre-COVID, I was just in every event. Like I was trying to get in every industry event. Like, I'm not going to lie to you. I used to do crazy stuff. Like I used to be in the venue before it opened. Let me tell you. And I would be in the bathroom, period, before the place opened, and I would wait till the venue started. If I wasn't invited, because like, you know, certain things, if you're not lit, you're not invited. So I would wait till it opened and I would come out the bathroom and I'll be in the event, period. That's a little jam. So, you know, if y'all want to do that crazy stuff, you can do that. But I was in all the stuff because of that. So
I was like, can you follow that up, please, Ms. Moore?
Yes. So I'm kind of the opposite. So I like to meet people in person. So in the beginning stages, I actually was doing, I went to every event. I went to, every, like, if I'm going to a club, I go talk to the DJs. I go talk to the owners because I'm also an event planner, too. So I have to work the room for both sides of my business. I'm a publicist and event planner. As it relates to the music industry. So I just make sure that wherever I'm at, any industry type of event, I talk to people, I make relationships. That's really what a publicist is. You make relationships and you maintain them. So my asset is like, I'm a people person and I'm better in person. So that's how I built my relationships. Like I got in the door at Rare Sound with Kay Kemp through meeting Ty Sanders and Adrian, aka Miss Reeves, stuff like that. I've also met Bow Wow's DJ at Escobar in Atlanta, you know, just talking to people. I will get up and go sit next to you and talk to you, introduce myself, see what it is that you do, especially if I already know who you are, because I do my research. So some people, I kind of already know who you are. Even if you're behind the scenes, you need to know the behind the scenes people. So that's how I started building my relationships and meeting people. And then from there, sometimes it's not what you know, but it's who you know. So with that being said, the people that I meet, they may have an invitation to 21 Savage birthday party. I got an invitation as well, just because of the relationships that I've already built in person and stuff like that. So that's, and even there, like I remember going to 21 Savage party and I left there with so many people, Instagram information, emails, business cards, like everybody in the room, you knew it was something that they was there for a reason. They was invited, you know what I'm saying? So it's important to have fun in this industry, but make the relationships while you're there. When you're in an event that's so personal like that, you need to do the work and build the relationships, meet people. Don't be shy, don't be scared.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. That's something I hear a lot nowadays is like, well, just, you know, being in these type of events is just really about who you know. So make sure y'all, anywhere y'all is, just make sure y'all take that opportunity. You never know who you might meet and who they might know, for real. And on top of that, just to add to that, make sure, I don't know if I said it before, but make sure y'all fill out that contact sheet too, so you all get a chance to network with everybody that's in this event right now. It's in the chat, so make sure y'all check that out and fill that out. Okay, so my next question is, so both of you guys, you know, spoke on having roles as public and public relations. So can you just explain to the audience what a publicist is and what the role is in an artist's career?
Let's
start with you, Ms. Moore.
The easiest way I tell people is I am the middle person. I'm the person that build, it bridges the gap between you and the public, right? So whatever you have going on, I'm advertising it. I'm putting it out in the public. I'm getting people to talk about it, making sure it's eye-catching. Even the little details of an Instagram post, anything from small scale to a big scale. And that's what a publicist is in the music industry per se. But that's the easiest way. I break it down to people. I bridge the gap between you and the public. What it is that you're doing, I'm putting it out there. I'm pushing it out there.
Okay. All right, can you follow that up, please? Oh, something going on. You got to unmute yourself for your talk.
Oh, sorry. But yeah, I definitely agree. It's the same. Same kind of thing. It's like you're bridging the gap between the media and the people. But really, you want to make sure that you're figuring out a specific angle too. Like, it's important. Like, you're not just gonna just send them an email about what the artist mm-hmm. is doing or whatever the case may be. You have to make sure that you're pitching an angle, but that's specific to that type of writer, because certain type of writers, they may write for a music publication, but that doesn't mean that they talk about that specific thing. You have to make sure that the angle is good for them because it's their style, and you want to continue that relationship too. You don't want to push something on them that's not really like what they like. But you're also you're working the public too, because a lot of, like, you know, there's blogging, but there's also like digital too, because, you know, like Instagram pages with larger followings that have that little short one-liner, you don't really get to write them a lot. You only get that one line, so you got to make sure it's interesting, catchy, or whatever. So just make sure that you're keeping things interesting and light, like what you'd want to read, like what catches your eye too, because, like, I feel like a lot of people overthink it, and you want to get like the publication to do all of this cool stuff, but what would you read? Like, what would catch your eye? Like, what would make you click the video or whatever? So think about that stuff too, I think.
Yeah, it's gotta be strategic.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So like with social media and everything being such a big part of the music industry now, like artists can be their own publicists, you know? So at what point do you feel an artist should go out and find a publicist or an artist manager? Like, what stage do you think an artist should start looking for that? And we'll start with you, Ms. Jocelyn.
I think that they should start looking when they have a moment that they're not sure how to capitalize on. Because I mean, like a lot of my clients now, like, they have a name, so it's easy for me to keep pushing it out or whatever. Like, I could keep, like, just because they're doing something, people want to see it, so it's easy. But for like an artist who's like maybe up and coming or whatever, I just hold off and just kind of get a moment, because like, it's like, yeah, you can get publications, you can get blogs or whatever, but it won't matter if it's not something that people really, really care about. And even it could be simple, like a viral TikTok dance, or like, you know, you got to meet this person and this bigger artist reposted you or whatever, or you got a feature with somebody. Like, it's got to be a story. Like, a lot of people come to me and I turn a lot of people down just because I just... You're going to be unhappy with me. You're going to end up being mad at me because you didn't get anywhere. But yeah, so I would say just make sure you have a moment, something that I could work with.
Okay. And you, Miss Moore?
She said a mouthful, really. That's exactly what I was about to say. I turned a lot of people down because I tell people I can't put anything out if you don't have anything to put out. If you haven't done any work, there's nothing that's keeping you relevant. And you don't have to already necessarily just be popping. Like, you could be up and coming, but up and coming doing what? What are you doing? You know what I'm saying? Like, for instance, I had a client, I have two different things I'm doing in my business, but this is just a piggyback moment. But I did Mop Freedom's album release party. He's up and coming artist. Some people may not know who he is, but he was on, Hustle and Flow with Cardi B and T.I. and Chance. So that's something that I could work with, you know what I'm saying? So it's a big event, a big moment. And even if he asked me to be a publicist, like, that's something that you can spin off, you can build that.
Okay, so do you guys have like a certain stage where you want an artist to come talk to you guys per se? Because you guys are more established, you know, so, and you have relationships already built. So do you want an artist to be at a certain point in their career? Or can they come at you, you know, anytime if their music is, you know, good enough? And we'll start with you, Ms. Jocelyn.
I think that, like, so I get a lot of So like the way I'm kind of, I structure my business now is a little bit different because now I'm able to like, thankfully, like, you know, thankfully, really, honestly, I'm able to like have more people on my team to like work projects for me. So what I ended up doing is I like, I'll take on like the bigger like clients or whatever, but the smaller stuff, what I'll end up doing, you know, just to make sure that my team is making money or whatever, I've created like a kind of like a three-step kind of like three-part kind of plan or whatever for like newer artists. So like we could start you off with like building your brand kind of thing. So like, you know, like, because a lot of people, you'd be surprised, like they'll come and they want publicity, but they don't realize that they don't have a bio, you don't have an EPK, you don't have anything, like you don't have the starter stuff. And then like for me to do the publicity, I need all of that stuff. So it's kind of will push me back and you'll be waiting, whatever. So I started people like that. And so it's okay. Like I can start you off there, but you're still going to need that moment. You know, you're still going to need that moment, whatever. So what I'll do is like, I'll come up with a little strategy for, to kind of build your Instagram or build your following or like build your SEO or whatever so that people can, you know, start to get to know you. And then we'll just pause for a minute, you know, pause for a minute. So you have all your tools, you know, and so that when you have that little moment or whatever, you can, we could use that or whatever for that. So people could come to me at all levels, really, because I consult, I do all that kind of stuff, but you still need that moment. You can't get around that.
Okay, go ahead, Ms. Moore.
Yeah, I was going to say, I do take the underdogs as well. I take the people that's up and coming. I do the same thing. Like it may not necessarily be a big moment for them, but the same thing she was saying was starting you off. Like I have different packages for different people at different stages of their performance or career. So that's actually necessary for different people. My lowest package, I mean, it does include the starter stuff, like we revamp your whole Instagram, all your social media pages. We do the EPK. We revamp your whole brand. You may not even have a brand. Some people don't even know that you need a brand. So that's, it works hand in hand like that. Like I'll take anybody that's starting off as well and just work your way up. We could build you up to that point.
Absolutely. I like that. So Ms. Moore, we'll start with you. So my question is, well, this is more for me, but there's a lot of aspiring artist managers in the event as well, you know, watching you in the audience and myself as well. So do you have any advice for someone who's just getting their feet into the game as far as artist management?
I find somebody in the industry that you can kind of, it's kind of hard to do, but it's not if you just really truly be genuine and you put yourself out there. But find somebody that you can kind of shadow or learn information from or get advice, like a mentor in the industry per se. That's what I did, especially when I got my foot in the door at Rare. I met up with a girl named Lex. She's an amazing publicist as well. And any questions I had, especially starting off in my business, I had a lot of questions and some stuff they don't just tell you, you know, you have to really figure it out on your own. And I feel like she was a blessing to me because she helped me figure out some things that I probably did need to do on my own. And I don't know, you just need to find somebody that's been where you're at and that knows how hard it is. Cause especially being a publicist, it's not as easy as it seems. It's not as simple as it seems. Like you have to strategize, you have to be creative. You have to dot your I's and cross your T's, all of that. And it falls on you too. But I just suggest you find somebody in the industry that you could trust and that's supportive and somebody that's been there and that's understanding as well.
Yeah, go ahead.
I think I would say don't be afraid to, you know, get behind something that you are passionate about. And then don't be also afraid to like kind of, you know, like don't be afraid to just do something, you know, when somebody asks you, because this is the story I'm going to give you. So like my first like management artist that I ever had, like I was doing their publicity. Like there was somebody that performed at that first show that I mentioned, like because like I originally had like this artist Flip the Nerd I was going to perform for me. He didn't perform for me because he was just getting signed, like he was just transitioning to getting his major deal. And that was the point where they were like, okay, these are the rules for performances or whatever, so he couldn't do it. So there was an artist, there was a group that I like, somebody put me on to, was like, yo, you should put them on or whatever. And I'm like, who are they? Whatever. They performed for me and I loved it. So they asked me to help them with publicity. And I, at the time, like I was just helping like underground artists. I didn't have any mainstream acts. I didn't have any mainstream contracts or, you know, label contracts or anything like that. So I was like, whatever. So y'all do it. They ended up asking me to be their manager and I've never managed anybody before. So I was like, I don't know. And, you know, I let them encourage me. You know, sometimes you gotta let people encourage you to do stuff because yes. you don't realize your potential until somebody says, you know, so till you do something that, you, that you're not comfortable with doing. So I did that and they went really far. Like, they have a distribution deal. They're doing well. They're good. Like, and that was because I took that leap. And because I did that, people saw what I did for them and they gave me, you know, that's how I got Don Q and that's how I, you know, started working with Atlantic and that's how I got Chef and all of them because everybody saw my management style and they liked, you know, how far I got these people and they liked how I work with hip hop artists and males and da 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 da. Like I've done so many other things because of that situation. Like, so I really, you know, I'm glad that I took that leap.
Absolutely. I love that. So this is my last question and we're going to get into the Q&A. But with everything going on, you know, COVID, you know, really affected the music industry a lot, you know, with artists, they either not dropping as much music or the music they do drop doesn't stick as much unless you're really up there. So, and, you know, nobody's able to tour or anything. So with in the wake of COVID, what can artists do to promote the music? Like, what are more creative ways to get the music going if they're just now starting out and it's a bad time? You feel me?
My favorite thing, I always tell people visuals. Like, if you can't do anything right now during the pandemic, some visuals is going to definitely get you some attention. Everybody's on Instagram all the time, all day. You can never go wrong with visuals. I don't care if it's just you in a studio. I don't care if it's a lyric visual. I don't care if it's a music video. I don't care. Visuals, that's my only tip right now, is so crucial.
Yeah, I definitely agree. Visuals too, and to put on those digital pages, like the pages with larger following. But also, like, just think about what is it that makes you interested outside of music too? Because, like, I had this somebody I just took on the other day. He basically like used to do he used to like be a pre-law student or whatever, and he just dropped all of that to do music. And even though he doesn't really have, like, I mean, his song has gone viral on TikTok. That's just like a side thing. That's the reason I took it, because I knew I could keep it going with that. But that little angle helped me with a lot of press, because it has nothing to do really with his music specifically. But people were like, from pre-law to music, why did he stop doing pre-law, you know, to be an artist? And that was just something I pulled from his everyday life. So I think artists got to start thinking about, like, stuff they've done in their life that may make them interesting or whatever. Because, you know, like, it's just like when you write a resume or something, like, what are some old things that you've done that may be relevant to whatever it is that you're trying to go for? You know, people, you never know. It might be something interesting and the press might want that angle or whatever, or that those digital pages may want it or whatever. And you could take them clips. So the music got to be good, though. Let's really talk about that. Like, everything you do, all those sprinkles you add don't matter if the music is wet. But if the music is good, you have a nice little angle, like, you know, people will gravitate towards it. You have the internet. Everybody's on the internet right now. Nobody doing nothing.
Yeah, I agree with that. And definitely, I feel like a lot of people now think it's cool to just be low-key. But, I mean, if you ain't up there, like, the weekend or something, you can't be low-key. You gotta be more open with yourself. And I definitely agree with the visuals, too. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, like I said, I want to be an artist manager. And I'm working with my first artist or whatever. And I'm telling them, like, and we just gonna load up, like, it's straight music and visuals, because ain't much else to do. So
yeah,
and you know.
I'm trying to tell you, y'all seen Megan and Cardi and Young Thug, everybody going crazy with the visuals lately, especially during COVID.
I seen Cardi's, yeah.
She going crazy
for sure. All right, well, my part is done. I thank y'all for answering my questions. Y'all made it so easy for me. Y'all kept it going. So we're gonna go ahead and go into the Q&A. So if anybody has any questions, just raise your hand and you'll get called on. And that's about it. You see, y'all already on it. All right, so we'll go on to Tiffany then until you figure it out.
Hi, this question is for the both of you guys. I was just wondering, like, what podcasts or publications you guys are listening to stay updated in the industry, or what like educational resources are you utilizing aside from, you know, your guys' experience?
You want to go ahead, Jocelyn?
I just read books. Like I just read books on my own time, because I don't like to be like too influenced by people's opinions. So like I like to just read books. Like I could show you what books I read, but like people on my team too, I let them tell me what's hot, what's going on, or whatever the case may be, because I don't like the internet stuff. Like you get like real clouded. That's just my opinion though. Like you get like clouded with like what people are doing. You forget what you're trying to do, whatever. So I try not to do too much of that. But I mean, besides like everyday stuff, like to know what's going on in the culture itself, I really just watch The Breakfast Club. Like that's it yes. for me. Like they gonna put you on, you're gonna know everything, and that's it. You should be like, everything else is what they talking about. To me.
Yes. But. Yes. I love The Breakfast Club. I watch them literally.
Yeah, that's it.
If not every day, every other day. I try to keep up with The Breakfast Club. They're always dropping the ladies and what's
they
going
know.
On
they
with
know
whoever, whenever. Also, don't sleep on Wendy. Wendy Williams is still my girl. She still got the little tea or you know, just little stuff like that. I do keep in touch with little daytime shows, radio stations, blogs, but for the most part, I am an Instagram and Twitter person. I will look at some hashtags and just see what's going on, what's popping, who's popping. It's always a new TikTok, it's always a new song, always a new dance. So I just try to keep up with today's stuff, with the new artists coming out. You know, I try to keep up with a lot of people. So that's how I keep up with who's who.
Are you reading then?
You missed. I'm sorry.
Oh, I was talking. Like,
I was about to go in my room. Tell us about to go on. Right now, I'm just reading. Let me show it to y'all. Damn, because I don't remember who it's by. But basically, it's a book on like how to have meaningful conversations and how to like stuff like that. Then I'm reading books on like sales pitches and stuff, like how to like specifically sell like products and stuff like that, because I'm looking to transition into more e-commerce stuff, and like I'll show you guys that. Well, you'll see if you guys follow me, you'll see what I'm going to be talking about. So I'm trying to figure out like what are the cool ways to e-commerce things. I'm not really into like day-to-day new stuff. It's not really my interest, to be honest with y'all. Like I just be wanting to learn like tangible skills, so I just
I was about to say that too. Like, besides all the stuff that I mentioned earlier with what I listen to keep up with who's who and what's what, to keep myself on my toes and my skills and stuff, like, it's just different little summits and modules that I keep up with. I told you I have the PR agency ready certification from the PR council. I keep up with any events that the PR council do because they try to keep you up on your toes. Me being at Rare Sound, we actually have a link that send us to different modules in the music industry, period. No matter what it is, like it tells you everything from behind the scenes to in front of the scenes to management to publicists to advertising to marketing to visuals to social media. It tells you everything. So I just try to take in a lot of reading like that, a lot of just like to keep myself up on my toes with my craft and what I do, as well as keeping in touch with what's going on in the industry.
Can I get some hand rubs for feeding your brain, please? Can I get
some? Oh, yeah. You got to. It's important. It's important to know what's going on in the industry, but it's also important to stay up to date with your craft, practice your craft.
Absolutely. But go ahead,
Josh. Another thing is, I'm trying to find this link for something that I could send y'all so y'all could do it. But basically, there's a, once you start getting more into, like the music industry and stuff like that, you start like working for labels and stuff, they email you what you need to know.
They'll
email you all of that. So that's why it's like, it's hard for me to say like what I'm looking at, because it's just like whatever they send me, you feel me? Like that's what I'll know And then they'll tell you, like, you know, that's how you know, like, what's the post up or whatever. Like, you know, it becomes like a little club type vibe. Mm-hmm. You know, so you'll get all of that stuff, and you don't have to like go too hard, you know, after that. But I'm trying to find something, because like prior to COVID, like my biggest thing, it's so crazy because now everything is digital, but like prior to COVID, I was traveling everywhere. Whatever conference was available, because I write, so I get a lot of, that's another thing I would tell y'all to do if y'all, you know, are trying to get into, I don't know if this is even going to happen anytime, so maybe 2022, but like conferences for me were a big deal because like I went in as a writer, so I would always get like media passes and stuff. Once you get a media pass, you know, you get behind the scenes, whatever, you get to meet people. That was a big deal for me. I would go wherever, like, you know, I'd fly to Florida, Texas, wherever they want me to go, because, you know, you get to meet people. But there's a conference I really like. It's called the BYOB retreat thing. I'm trying to find the link because now it's completely free and it's online.
Oh yeah, please drop down in the chat when you.
Yeah, I'm trying to
drop that in the chat because the one I'm going to is virtual.
I'm trying to find the real link because they have like a like a RSVP link thing or whatever. But it was like when I used to go, the conference was probably like $400 a ticket. But like, you know, I was going as a writer, so I was getting in or whatever. But I was like, I would have paid, you know. Back then, I didn't have it like that, but. If I had it, I would go. Like, because the people you meet there is like insane. Like, but I'm trying to figure this out. I'm gonna send y'all this thing, this part
definitely
of it.
Drop
you
this.
Tell me.
Sure. Yeah, why are you trying to find that? I'm gonna have Justin ask his question. I've been trying to get on for a minute.
Okay.
All right, can y'all hear me now?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
All right, here thank you go, you, thank you. I appreciate it. Tyler, firstly, thank you for saying my name correctly. I am Jocelyn Artis. I'm here in Northern Virginia. I'm an audio director, you know, everything audio, A&R, as well as an artist. And I have basically two questions. So I think, ladies, you could do one of each, you know, whatever you feel most comfortable. I just did a project with a guy, Damian Lewis. He's in Orlando, Florida. Put out his project in September. And it went gold before December, right at the beginning of December. So you guys mentioned about this moment of that you have to have. And I loved how it was worded. So I've been trying to figure out, you know, help him capitalize on this moment. Now he's done this without any publications. He's just been grinding with promoting and playlisting. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to know, what are some ways, I guess, from a PR standpoint, as well as an artist manager, how would you capitalize on that? And then my second question is, do you guys do anything with sync? What's your strategy? How do you approach that? And, you know, share any experience that you've had in the past.
So the first question is you're asking, like, how would you pitch him specifically? Like what he was doing?
Yeah, so since he's gone gold, again, with very limited, like, I think, we had a meeting, so this is February, probably beginning of January, about things to capitalize, things to do to capitalize on going gold, you know, creating a community, again, more visuals, that type of thing. But because you guys brought it up, it's like, man, this is a moment. And so any other ideas on how to get him out there more, considering he's had this big milestone?
Is this like a first in any way?
Yes,
like,
it is a first, yep.
No, like, I mean, like... first in his label or first in the, you know, like first, like maybe like the first in his neighborhood, like something that sounds
He just straight independent. I do his I engineer his project, so he's solo, no backing, no nothing.
Where's
like
he from?
All him. Orlando, Florida.
Like what, is there like, I'm not familiar with Orlando, but like, is there like a neighborhood like that people would recognize or something?
I don't know it off gate.
Yeah.
What I would say is pick like the name of the area, like so wherever, like, you know, like somebody, whatever his name is on from this specific place is the first person to go. And then you pitch it to those independent publications that are in that area.
Right.
Because it'll just like, you have to make it sound, it's big, obviously, but make it sound even bigger, like first black man from
whatever. He's Haitian too, so he's like a Haitian American, so
all of that, like that. All of that.
Okay, Okay.
Take all of them words and put it together. Like, gotcha. But when it comes to sync, I do sync stuff, but right now I have a deal with Sony, so I do like all my syncs with them. Right. And then I also do one with 300. So but it's still like a pitching process. They'll send me like what they're looking for, word for word, like this specific show or whatever. And you just gotta, it's still kind of like a competition too, because there's other people that are still pitching, even though you're like, you know, you're, my company is like signed to them. So like I don't technically get first dibs still, but I get like first dibs from like a stranger, right. But you still have to like make sure your stuff is like really directly to what they're looking for and stuff like that. So I guess you could say the best thing you do is just make sure you have like more than one option. Maybe have two or three, so that like if they don't like it, you could be faster than somebody else that has to fix theirs.
Right, gotcha.
No, I'm about to say she said exactly what I was about to say. Make sure you have more than one option for real. You don't want to take that route. You want to have a backup, more than one.
It's like you saying that made me think of ESPN, where they'd be like having them weird stats, be like, first person to make a layup on a Thursday or something like that.
But it's like, no way, he was the first person to do that.
No way, like, yeah. But great question.
Gotta have an attention grabber.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Great question. All right, Cardi, you go ahead, ask your question.
Hi, ladies. Thank you so much for, you know, talking to us this afternoon. So, as I mentioned earlier, I'm at the process of launching my own music management firm that's based in Ohio for Ohio artists. And my question for you is, as far as building up the management team that's gonna be assisting me with the artists, what have you guys seen in your careers as to like what to look out for employees like that and what to stay away from, or any other advice like around that?
I would say do it. Oh, sorry, go ahead.
No, I was about to tell you, go ahead, because I'm not a manager, so have a management team like that. Like, you know, I'm around people like that, but I'm not a manager.
Mm-hmm. I would say try to do it. This is like the opposite of what you ask it, but I would say do it by yourself as long as you possibly can. Because honestly, like, I love my team. Like, don't unquote me. You feel me? Like, don't quote me. Like, I love my team. But like, you don't. Like, because I love my team, I listen to them a lot. Like, I listen to their opinions and I take it all in and all that type of stuff. But you don't realize, like, you know, how many directions you'll start pulling yourself because so many people saying stuff. Oh, we should take this. We should do this. Like, so it's crazy because, like, people know me in New York because I work with, like, all of the hip-hop artists. Like, you know, besides the ones that I manage, like I tour managed Dave East and Mad, you know, like all hip hop, like that's what you know me as, but I don't even like that. Right. Like, I don't even, like, it's crazy that it happened to me, but that's not even my style. Like, I like weird ass shit. Like, I like other stuff, but that's just not what was going to propel me. You feel me? That's what happened. But so now I'm like, I want to go into Afrobeat. So I started managing Kiz Daniel, who's big in Nigeria, and Kiddo, who's a big producer out there too. And I'm like, that's what I want to do.
Right.
My team is like, what's happening with hip hop? I'm like, what you mean? Like, but now I can't do that because it's a company now.
Right.
You know, like, I got to do what everybody wants to do. But see, if I was by myself for a little longer, you know, I could just do what I want to do, which sounds kind of weird, but like, you know, so I guess the advice would be like, try to work with people who are in your same, like have your same wave kind of length. Because like, there's a lot of people on my team though that really do like Afrobeats. So they're like super hype, you know, right. But then there's people over there. So now what I did was I was going to post about this, so y'all getting an exclusive, but I partnered with No Jumper because I'm about to start doing like a whole segment on that type of stuff, you know, so I keep all those the people on my team happy. So I'm going to do a monthly segment with like people that I like, but I have one of my writers who's going to be doing weekly articles on them, on like those hip hop, all of that stuff that little jumper likes and all that kind of stuff. So I can keep my people happy, but you see how the lengths I had to go,
right?
Because I have a whole big team of people and everybody wants to do other stuff. So I would just say, try to do as much as you can, like until you really, really, really can't anymore. You know, like, it's like, all right, I need help. But if you don't need help, don't just do what you gotta do by yourself.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Can I get a hand rub for No Jumper, please? Can I get a hand
exactly.
rub?
Exactly. That's
not gonna be lit. It's gonna be lit for real. Mm-hmm.
Dang, y'all is out here working. I'm 21. Like, I need to step it up.
Working.
You right on track, man.
I need to step mm-hmm. it up for sure. We got one more question, then we're gonna go into the listening session. I believe it was Taylor. Taylor, you wanna ask your question now?
Hear me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, cool. So I'm Taylor, and I actually graduated with a PR degree in December 2019 before COVID hit and everything just went to crap, basically. And so through just, like, my classes and stuff, like, I can write, like, a mean email. I know how to write well and everything. But I have an issue with, like, if I meet new people, like, introducing myself is something that I personally struggle with. But once, like, a conversation gets going, like, I'm fine. So I guess my question is, like, do you have any suggestions on how to, like, introduce yourself, like, properly to somebody that, like, has no idea who you are or anything like that, that doesn't make you sound like, oh, like, give me, like, a job or something like that, like, just chill way to introduce yourself, I guess.
Yeah, I can answer that question because I do that a lot, just meeting people, just walk up talking to them. But it took me a while to get to that point. What I used to do, I used to practice my elevator pitch. And with that, I perfected it to where it didn't sound so routine. It didn't sound so, hi, I'm Aliyah. I do this, 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 this. You got to make it flow, natural conversation, and just get comfortable. When you're there and you're in front of whoever you want to talk to, just take a second and breathe. Don't go up there until you're ready. You don't have to rush, but don't let the opportunity slip away from you. Just breathe, take a moment, relax, remember who you are and your purpose, and remember what it is that you do. You're dope. You know you have you have some type of craft. There's something about you that makes you special, something about you that makes you stand out. Work on that, just act on that. We as publicists, we know how to brand other people, but it's as just as important to brand yourself. You get what I'm saying? So make sure you just practice your elevator pitch, breathe, relax, and just sell yourself, brand yourself. It's literally that simple, but it takes practice.
Definitely. I will also say my favorite line is like, hey, I noticed that you're struggling with, like, I noticed that you're missing, you know, like, because it shows your interest, you know, that you've been paying attention to them. It shows that you're willing to lend a hand, you know, and then you can offer, like, specifically, like, you know, so, like, say, like, it could be something little, like, if you see, like, this, like, influencer or whatever that you look at badge or whatever, they could be spelling stuff wrong,
mm-hmm.
type shit, mm-hmm. like, you know, they're putting up their articles and they're spelling stuff wrong. And you're like, hey, I noticed that you da 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 da. I'd be totally happy to proofread all of your posts moving forward. You know, it's very specific, very direct. So they're like, oh, okay, wait a minute. I need that. I need a proofreader type of thing or whatever, like a writer or whatever you're good at. You know, like, I'm a really strong box lifter. Okay. And if you need to box lift it, I can do that. You know, they'd be like, you know what? We're moving into a new office. We could use, because you'd be surprised. People don't want to lift boxes. That was a random thought. But people don't want to do stuff like that, like sweep the floor or lift the boxes. And if you're okay with doing that, you never know. They don't need that. And the next thing you know, you're over there doing that other stuff. Mm-hmm. So lift them boxes, period.
Lift the boxes, man.
Lift the boxes. Lift the boxes.
Like you said, know your strength. Like you said, I write them an email. Like, let them know. Like, I write them an email. You feel me? Let them know. Yeah, for real. Hashtag lift them boxes. I love that for sure.
So, thank you.
That was great, man. So we're going to go ahead and bust into this listening session. I'm going to hand it over to Big B's over there. He going to get it. You know, we're going to hear some tunes. See how y'all doing. See how y'all sounding. All right.
Thank you, Tyler, for all of that. That was fire. I hope everybody had a good time. One more time, hand rubs. Yeah, shit was tough. So we got a couple new releases that we're ready to share. We got a couple, definitely a lot. We're gonna start with Chris. All right.
Baby, I'm my mother's son. I just dropped some heat. Ooh, damn, I got another one. I just took an L, bounce back. I had to double up. Niggas like the beef. You should see
my
the
body
way
is moving. That means something.
Ooh, got us chilling on the beachfront. Sister brought some friends, so you know I hit at least one. Pop a whip and scope the city. Dangerous, gotta keep one. Oh man, niggas gotta eat, huh?
I've been chilling shoreside, shorty on the beachfront. Tell me what's the soul tie? I ain't trying to lease one. Cutting up, I think I got her on the leash, but I can never mind. I know these hoes sneaking. Walk on the scene, I know I'm looking.
I like this.
Yes, I step out, but I am not creasing. It don't come with ease, depending on the season. My focus been on you, talking like it's recent.
She don't like my attitude, baby, I'm my mother's son. I just dropped some heat, ooh, damn, I got another one. I just took an L, bounce back, I had to double up. Niggas like the beef, you should see the way I cut it up. Ooh, got us chillin' on the beachfront. Sister brought some friends, so you know I hit at least one. Top up with the scope, the city dangerous, gotta keep one. Oh man, niggas gotta eat, huh? Hopped out clean with the dirty, bring the mops out. Summertime flow like it's time to bring the tops down. Told you it was up, now it's up, that bitch is stuck now. 12 hot, block hot, then the cops out. Everybody in the same lane, I had to swerve it. Last shit was down bad.
That was just a snippet. I can only play a minute and a half.
That was hard, man.
Yeah, shout out Chris.
Give him a hand rub. But that was, I know he said, you know, I hit at least one. Hey, what song is that?
Something about soul tie. I don't want at least one. I said, okay.
That was hard, though.
That was fire. I fuck with that.
All right. Shout out Chris. We got Elsie, another community member. Yeah, also, Chris, drop the links, bro.
Yeah, hey, you have to send me that, too. I like that.
Hey. Next up is Elsie, and this is Icarus. Play a minute and a half, but that was Elsie with Icarus. I'm not really paying attention, but I hope you guys are showing love in the chat.
Absolutely.
I like that. That sounds like something for sync.
Yeah. Tight. Make sure you guys are showing love. Next up, we got Julius. I wonder if this is a new song, but I will share my screen and we will find out together. Oh, hell yeah. Cool. This is a new song by Julius. It's called All In. I think it's out right now, too. So
what's your name?
It's Julian.
What is your worth? Do you got goals, I like ambition. What's on your mind? Do you got a type? Cause I got a vision. Let's run up a bag and run to the bank like we on a mission. Tell me you're willing to go, because I'm willing, girl, just let me know. I'll be waiting for you outside, pick you up when I slide. Set a destination on the road we can go. Put my all in it like I'm betting on my last dime. Because I'm ready for a life. Hey, girl, I'm all in. Is you down to risk it all until we ball in? Let's make a play. Cause girl, I'm all in.
See, I got a plan to hit up a play and run up these bands. All of my mans, we got it for plug, it's high on demand. All that I can, I'm doing whatever just to be better. Can you understand? Let's do it together, go half on whatever. Split it up, double up, hurry up, let's slide out. Baby, she feeling the vibe, jump up inside, let's ride out. No distractions, all actions, so turn off the phone, ain't no calling. We in too deep, falling, give me 6 feet, cause girl, we all in.
I'm gonna let you guys stream that. that's on Spotify right now. All in. Yeah, be sure to show some love. I think that was all produced, mixed, and mastered by Julius.
He had his own time on it.
Yeah, and that was his family too. I think a bunch of the features are all like cousins and stuff. So shout out Julius.
Shout out Julius.
We're gonna keep it moving. We got Marcos. I will share my screen. Yeah, right on. Type beat. I like that. I've been going kind of fast, but you guys want to maybe speak a little? Marcos, you want to talk a little bit about your song? Maybe we can get some feedback from our panelists too.
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Yeah, that one was I made that all in just a couple hours. I was just vibing. Yeah, I just really liked it in the end. It all just came together.
Do we have Jocelyn or Miss Moore? Do you guys have any thoughts about really anything that we've listened to so far? We might have lost both panelists.
I think Miss Moore was out for a second.
No, I'm back.
Okay.
Did you happen to catch that Mobius type beat,
Miss Moore? I did. I only left for a second. I didn't even mean to.
Wait.
Send me all of these when it's done?
Okay.
And like people's Instagrams and stuff too, so I could like follow people, because I also have I started up my blog, The Playground, where I like repost artist stuff, so I want to like repost some of these.
Hey, make sure y'all follow back too. I get y'all follow and follow me back. It's cool though. It, I ain't cool. When y'all get a chance, you know.
That's definitely something we can make happen. Yeah, we're gonna keep it moving then. We got She Knows Me by Jarrell. I think this is new, so we are lucky. We are in luck. 1 second. Sorry, guys. What the fuck? Sorry. This is Desert Island by She Knows Me by Jarrell. You want to talk about the song a little bit? Maybe let us know when it's dropping.
Okay, because I need that. Can I have that song? I want it.
I got you. I can send that to you, no problem. Yeah, that was me and my best friends. He made the beat and everything. Hopped on the chorus. I made the verse. We just made that in the room, like just on some chill vibes type shit. So yeah, it's good. I'm about to write that one out real soon. I got the cover art, everything, so it's gonna come.
But yeah, I can send it to you. DM me today.
Okay, I got super
shots. Hey, shout out to all the talent in the building. We got one more song. This is Jasmine. This is unmastered, but it's definitely mixed. So we got a little snippet. I'm gonna share my screen.
Been breaking the locks, been opening doors. See, now life is what you make it. Remember those nights I was sleeping in the basement in my bro's crib. But just the air mattress keep me from the flow. Put the duffel bag of dirty laundry right beside me, cause I got kicked out from the last shit I was staying at. Thought it was it. Finally moving out my grandma's crib, but shit didn't pan out. But I'm never switching up the plans, no. Now we back in the hood, Cliff, Montbello Road, nigga.
Yeah. If I could, I would do it all again. Ooh, I won't take it back. It's what made me who I am. I've been on my shit, working hard as shit. But you know what they say. Too far.
was in need, making a move, feeling desperate with my lows. I can't lie, been feeling cuffing way too long with that. I'm breaking down with every single step. When I'm moving back, I can't relax. I'm going to hard to grow, nigga. Shit that make me nervous, cause I can see the folding niggas when they start to lose ambition. Get stuck in they mental prisons, premonitions getting darker. Hope screaming at the top of their lungs, but nobody ever be hearing shit or feeling shit. Some niggas often lose their money, go numb. But being cold is just the norm and shit. Made me realize you ain't gotta die just to be dead, my nigga. So what you saying, nigga? I ain't trying to make the same mistakes and end up in the graveyard. So I tell my niggas go hard, cause it's the shit we up against. Devils trying to downplay on your dreams, it's like they got an anger grip, but I ain't shaking, no, no, not me. See my energy multiply, niggas, it's always on the rise, like,
If I could.
Damn. I want to let that one play out a little bit. Damn.
I need that one, too.
Yeah. Jasmine, yeah, you want to talk about it a little bit, man? That was awesome.
I appreciate that, bro. Hold on. Can you hear me?
Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. I bet. Thank y'all for playing that first and foremost. But really, that song right there is really to explain like my life, like real life, and in terms of like tying in mental health and how you know, how I've been moving. And you know, I just really wanted to give that motivation to people that are actually going through these rough times as of right now. Be like, you know,
fucking COVID. Literally saying.
Oh, shoot. I don't know who that was, but shout out to them too. But yeah, so like really going through these tough times and really like giving that hope and that motivation to make sure like, yo, even though we going through this, you can still flip that pain and turn it into a positive. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, that's the intro for the actual EP that I'm about to drop. So I really appreciate y'all rocking with it for real. All
right. Miss Moore, you got any thoughts you want to share about it?
Or I need it.
Stay less. I got you.
Jocelyn, I don't know if you're around. That's cool. I just wanted to say, I know a lot of people say it's, you sound like Kendrick, but I think you sound like Nip, and I think that's
true.
Yeah. So,
shit talk. Well, bro, I appreciate that. Nip's been a big influence for these, you know, these past couple months as well. So, I've definitely been listening to Nip a lot. Yeah.
Tough. I think that's it for me. Tyler or Lexi, if you guys want to.
Jasmir, I know somebody asked for your IG, if you can put that in the chat.
Oh, that's right. I know
people can connect with you. Also the contact sheet, I'm gonna post that one more time for everyone to continue to connect.
Yeah, make sure y'all fill that out for sure. But I was gonna go ahead and drop a little freestyle for y'all. I'm playing, but
The people need to hear it.
We got some very talented people though, for sure. Like, y'all sound great. I'll be coming here sometimes expecting something crazy to come up, but it don't ever happen. Like, I'll be ready to sit here and turn my camera off and laugh at y'all, but I don't get the chance to. So y'all do great every time y'all pop on, for sure. But is that all for the listening session then?
Yeah, we're good.
All right, cool. So whew, that is our event, y'all. That's our event. How'd I do? Let me see the hand rub.
Well, you did good. Y'all did so good. Thank y'all so much for having me.
Hand rubs, man. That was great.
Yeah, this is dope.
I appreciate it. I just want to thank everybody for coming out. I want to thank our panelists for showing up, for sure. Please make sure y'all sign that contact sheet. Like I said, you know, get y'all chances to network with everybody. We got some talented people in here. You know, everybody want to do something, so y'all here for a reason. Like they were saying, y'all here for a reason. So make sure y'all show up next week. We'll be having our spoken word and our poetry event. So that's gonna be a good one too. That's gonna be, you know, that's gonna be another one. Y'all can't.
And please send it to me. Send me y'all stuff. If you perform today, like I mean, if you played, your music was played today, send it to me in the DM because I have like the whole publication and I want to start putting some stuff up. But besides that, maybe I could like partner with y'all, like put like finesse pics on my blog too. You feel me?
Right here. I'll be reaching out.
send it to me because right now I'm only doing like visual. You can follow. It's called the Press Playground right now. I'm trying to get the Instagram the playground, but whatever. If not, I'm gonna change it to the Playground the Mag. But right now it's Press Playground. If you look at it, like just visuals right now. But I'm trying to figure out a way maybe to incorporate like the cover art and I'll play the music in the background. So if you have a visual, definitely send it. If you don't, for now, I maybe do a playlist or something, but still send it over there, and I'll put it up.
Absolutely. Jocelyn and Miss Moore, we appreciate you both so much.
Absolutely. No problem.
Seriously. Thank y'all so much for having me.
Yeah, for sure. So
it's Jocelyn A. Rivera. I see somebody said, what's my Instagram? Oh, I can type here. Whoa.
Yeah, so y'all ain't got to go home, but y'all got to get off of Zoom. So that's it. So
all right, bye, y'all.
It was great. Huh?
I was just going to say, for everyone who really enjoyed the Finessed community, we do have a membership community, and I just put in the website there if you're interested in attending all of our events and, you know, collaborating with various artists and all of that. But that's all I had to say.
And make sure y'all send it out if y'all know people, too. You know, the more people, the merrier. It was great. Y'all very talented. I appreciate it, so.
All right, everybody. Thank you so much, everyone. Congratulations to Jocelyn for the big sign. And good job, Tyler. We will see everybody next week. Thank you, guys. Bye.
Have a good one, y'all. Thank y'all again.
Bye, y'all.